I never thought that studying physics would lead me to design. But with a career in academia, I get to invent new materials at the atomic level. Hi. My name is Ben Powell, and I'm a professor of theoretical physics at the University of Queensland, which is on the lands of the Turrbal and Jagera people. My role is incredibly varied. I teach undergraduates and PhD students. I do research and lead a team of other researchers. In condensed matter physics, we use quantum mechanics to describe the properties of materials that involve unbelievably large numbers of particles. For example, in a sugar cube, you have Avogadro's number of electrons interacting with one another. Condensed matter physics is the largest field of physics. One of the things that's most fun about condensed matter physics is the crossover with the rest of science, from particle physics to chemistry. Some of the key questions that I ask are about what happens when astronomically large numbers of particles interact with one another. Answering these questions would help us to design new materials with properties enabling dramatic new technologies. I'm interested in switches that are as small as a single molecule, and superconductors, materials that conduct electricity without losing any energy. As a kid, I loved maths and science. Then, at university, I discovered that theoretical physicists use maths to describe the real world. This led me to do a PhD in theoretical physics, which set me up for a career in academia. As a theoretical physicist, I get to use maths and supercomputers to model the world. These are some of the basic equations that describe superconductivity. And this is a simple model of molecular switches. Molecular switches are single molecules that have two internal states. They can be switched using light, electricity, or temperature, and they have the potential to be used in phones and computers to make them smaller and more energy efficient. I really enjoy the feeling when I figure something out, and I know that no one else has understood that before, even if it's just a small thing. It's fun when you tell someone else about it and they're as excited as you are. These are some of the basic equations that describe superconductors, materials that conduct electricity without losing any energy. If we could make them work at room temperature, we could cover the outback in solar panels and transport all the energy without losing any to capital cities. Working in academia requires some hard work and some luck, as getting into the field is very competitive. But it's a great job because I get to ask and answer the questions that interest me most about the world and how it works. I love it when I read about an experiment and stop and ask, how does that work? And then later, maybe years later, I can explain it. It means I can help solve long-term problems. For example, how can we generate enough electricity for modern life without destroying the planet? I also love that I get to work with people from all around the world. I've worked closely with people from every continent and from all different backgrounds. For a career in scientific research, it's important to stay interested in the world around you. My advice is to study physics because it sets you up for many potential careers in different areas. As a condensed matter theorist, the ultimate question for me is how do we design new materials that can do new things? Materials with amazing new properties could solve some of the biggest problems. For example, if we had superconductors that worked at room temperature, we could have almost limitless clean energy. That's why I love condensed matter. I can use abstract ideas from quantum mechanics to come up with cool new ways to solve real world problems.